your question. Hypothetical. Let's say you could live to be 90 years old.
Okay.
And the last 60 years of your life, you could have the body of a 30-year-old or the mind of a 30-year-old.
Okay.
Which would you choose? And why?
A body of a 30-year-old?
Yeah.
Mind?
Yeah, if you're gonna live to be 90. Okay. Okay. But right. And for 60 years of your life, from 30 all the way to 90, you can have the mind of a 30-year-old, which means you're never get old. You'll never get feeble or senile or whatever. Okay. Or you can have the body of a 30-year-old. Basically, you'd look 30 years old for the whole time.
Honestly, I would choose the mind, dude.
There you go.
I mean, a body of a 30-year-old, I mean, mm-hmm. It's rather subjective, but like having like a 30-year-old mind.
Yeah.
Like I feel like, I mean, I'm 25, but like if you're 30, mm-hmm. I feel like you're still like open to stuff. Like,
right.
Open to new ideas. I mean, you see people that are like going through like midlife crisis and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And they turn out their lives around. I mean,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would rather definitely go with the mind. I mean,
okay.
There's so many things that you can.
Cool.
I guess your brain in general is so valuable.
Right. A secret hunch about how you will die.
A secret hunch?
Yeah, like.
Wait, I'm having a thought moment. Like.
Well, this is one of the. These questions, I got these off of from Princeton University.
Alright.
And they help connect with people. You know? So, like, let's say we all know we're gonna die someday.
Alright.
Some people think they're gonna have a heart attack or diabetes or whatever. But do you have a hunch about how you might die?
Yes.
And what is that?
Well, it's actually my fear, but it's just rather.
Okay.
Secretly, like.
You'd be by yourself when you go.
Yeah, I'd be by myself, and no one's gonna notice maybe for like 2 weeks until I start smelling stuff. But, yeah, it's just.
Okay.
I just tend to just think about that.
Okay. We'll move off of that one. That's a little dark. Yeah, we'll go with something a little lighter.
It is very dark.
Do you have. Name three things that you and your partner have in common. Name three things you and your last partner had in common.
Well, I never had a partner ever.
You've never been with anybody.
Oh,
you've
no,
never.
Never.
You've never been in love. You've never had that.
No, never. It's just one.
Do you purposely avoid that?
Yes and no. I think one is like having like growing up in a different culture is like one of the things that like just prevented me from like connecting with people. Mm-hmm. And two, it's like I think in the U.S. it's like fairly easy to like. Start relationships because you know when you're in your teens you start crushing on people, but I mean in my country it's like no you don't do that, like focus on school, like
wow.
Yeah, that's what my parents do.
Okay, you're 25 years old.
I am 25,
so you're young, you still have time.
Yeah, well, you know, my parents don't know about
dude, you know. Yeah, I understand. I mean, clearly you care a lot about your family, but at some point you're going to have to start living part of your life for you, man.
True, but I mean, it's like, in a sense, like, they should